Hello everybody, I wanted to discuss this series of x-rays on the same patient because there's just so much to learn from it. This is a 20-something year old lady who presents like a week after giving birth to a baby with right-sided flank pain. And she had a cough, some history of fevers, on auscultation she had some crackles and bronchi, especially in the right lower base of the lungs. And this x-ray right here, shows a definite finding of a right posterior lobe pneumonia. Right, this whole area right here is definitely darker compared to this side here. So that's a right posterior lobe pneumonia. The doctor gave her some breathing treatments, put her on doxycycline, which is an adequate antibiotic for outpatient treatment of pneumonia, and she was discharged home. She presented 2 days later at this point with 103 fever, tachycardia in the 160s, and of course feeling very, very sick. You can see that the pneumonia that was there before is now progressed to this large area here. This is the diaphragm still right here. The diaphragm right here. So this whole area is pneumonia and effusion. So she had developed right pleural effusion, and all this area here is a progression of the pneumonia. Plus, she was acting very sick. She was admitted to the ICU under IV antibiotics and respiratory treatments. She wasn't doing all that well. They get a CAT scan the next day, and it only showed that she had pneumonia with pleural effusion, but she also had a pulmonary embolism. Of course, this wasn't suspected because she came with a fever, tachycardia, and findings very much consistent with pneumonia, but of course it can get complicated. She can have all the symptoms. You can see now the whole area here looks a little like fluid filled, a little more congested, starting to show some changes here like fluffy type infiltrates, and the heart side's pretty much getting bigger every time we do an x-ray. And then this is the last x-ray I have on this patient. And you can see right here the endotracheal tube is put in. It's got a marking because it's kind of a little bit too far. It needs to be brought up a little bit. She also, so this is the endotracheal tube coming in like that. She also has a gastric tube right here coming down. And you can see the heart size big, has fluffy infiltrates. The pneumonia seems to have gotten better. But now look at what we call the cephalization, kind of like the fluid all the way up. This particular patient ended up developing congestive heart failure along with the pulmonary embolism, along with the pneumonia. We think either from being so sick that she developed these findings, or she developed what is called postpartum cardiomyopathy, which is heart dysfunction of the pump function, and they start retaining fluid and develop pulmonary edema. On either case, because of the cardiomyopathy, she's a very high risk for arrhythmias. She ended up needing a life vest. It's actually a vest they put on the chart, on the chest. And if they develop a dangerous arrhythmia, then it shocks them back into rhythm. So this is cool case for learning, of course not for the patient, but because there's so many findings that you can see the progression from a patient look clinically very well with a low-grade fever, a little tachycardia, just some mild respiratory findings, to this, where she was 103 fever, severe tachycardia, obviously septic, and then pulmonary embolism, and then cardiomyopathy, and then pulmonary edema, intubated, very, very sick patient. So also brings up the question that if she was this well before, you know, could we have done anything different initially? And after review and review with other physicians, there really wasn't anything there to suspect such a bad disease process. Other maybe that the fact that because she was postpartum, she was in the hospital about a week ago, that this could have indeed be a hospital-acquired pneumonia, which makes it high risk because of the MDR, multiple drug resistance associated with hospital-acquired pneumonia. So then the antibiotics given for community-acquired pneumonia might not be as efficient or efficacious on this particular patient. Other than that, there's really a normal, well-looking patient, healthy and young, with a little pneumonia. There was no reason to admit her for this, at least not clinically, until she developed these findings here. So that's it for this teaching point, and I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot. Bye-bye.